Hello everyone and welcome to another Coding Fundamentals in GML tutorial. My name is Sam Spade and in this tutorial we'll be talking about queues. As with all of our data structure videos, I want to remind you that a data structure is a collection of values, the relationships among those values, and how you interact with those values. I also want to remind you to watch the introductions part 1 and part 2 for things that are true for all data structures in GameMaker Studio 2. So a queue is a first-in, first-out data structure. What this means is that the first data into the data structure is the first data that comes out of the data structure. You can think of this much like a line or a queue in real life, where people line up and the first people in the line are the first people to get out of the line. With a queue, there are a couple key terms to understand. We have the queue itself, we have the head and the tail, and then we have the commands in queue, which means add to the queue, and queue always gets added to the end or the tail, and dequeue, which will remove from the head of the queue. So we have head and tail, and then dequeue, which removes, and enqueue, which adds, where again, we're adding to the end and removing from the front. And that's really all you can do with queues. You can add things to them, and they'll always be added to the tail, or you can remove things from them, and they'll always be removed from the head. You can also get the size of the queue or see if it's empty. You can clear it, and you can read the head and tail values without actually removing either of them. As you might expect, queues are great for when you need things to go into a queue or a line, such as a message queue or event queue. And they're also used for various algorithms, such as breadth first search. So let's jump over to GameMaker Studio 2 and walk through these functions. So we have our breakpoint as always. We're going to use dsqcreate to create the data structure. Now we're going to use dsqenqueue, which means add to the data structure. We're going to tell GameMaker Studio 2 to look at this as a queue. So here we go. So we've added 1, 2, and 3. And notice how 1, 2, and 3 were added, and 1 is still the first position. And every time we add, we're going to add to the end or the tail of the queue. So we're going to add 4 now. 4 goes down there. We're going to add 5. 5 goes down there. And now we're going to go through the queue and we're going to look at the head and tail, and then we're going to dequeue or remove the value from the head. So I'm just going to initialize these variables. We're going to repeat for the size of the queue, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then again, we're going to look at the head and tail values with dsqhead and dsqtail. So we can see 1 and 5, 1 and 5, the head and the tail, and then we're going to dequeue. And with dequeue, that removes that value from the data structure. So we have dequeued the head, which again is 1, and we got that value. We're going to go through it again, remove 2, next value will be 3, next value will be 4, next value will be 5. And so you can see how this is very useful for anything that you want to act like a queue or a line. Let's say you have a bunch of messages that you want to be dealt with, or a bunch of alerts that you want to be dealt with in the order that they're generated. You would put those alerts into the queue as they're generated, and then you would deal with them by dequeuing or removing them from the queue. And of course, at the end, we're going to destroy our data structure, as always. It's now destroyed, and that's it. So, in summary, queues store information in a first-in, first-out structure. You can interact with the queue by enqueuing or dequeuing data, by adding or removing, and you add to the tail and remove from the head. They're useful for things like queuing events or for algorithms such as breadth first search. Queues are also a data structure that don't have an accessor because, again, having an accessor wouldn't make any sense for a queue where all you can really do is add things to the end of it and remove things from the front of it. As always, the links on this slide will be below, along with links to the source code and the slides themselves. And that's it. Thanks for watching.